In terms of mammals, what we see immediately across the KT boundary, which is actually represented in this vertebrate microfossil site at Constantius, is that there are actually very few species that survive, and those that survive tend to be mouse-like animals, insect-eating animals, and fairly generalized in their ecology. And that carries on for about 200,000 years after the KT impact. And then we start to see an influx of mammals that are immigrating into this area in northeastern Montana. And we start to see evolution taking place within these animals here, radiating into different forms. One of the groups that shows up in the second level represented in this 1 million year span are the archaic ungulates and the primates. So archaic ungulates and primates go on to become very species rich in this area and become a dominant aspect of this fauna here. One other thing that we see here is that in addition to the numbers of species that are showing up in this area, going from very few numbers to much greater numbers within about 600,000 years, we also see them taking on different ways of life, different ecologies. Things are moving from simply just eating insects to starting to take on more plant material into their diet, specialists on fruits, specialists on leaves, animals that are starting to take on different locomotor behaviors, from simply scrambling on the ground to becoming diggers, and some that are becoming climbers into trees, and a variety of forms of life and body sizes that take place within this first 1 million years worth of time that's represented here in northeastern Montana by the Tulloch Formation.